Hi, my name is Brian Haskett with Techniks Tool Group. I want to take a short bit of time today to go over some startup and quick tips and tricks when using our spinner deburring equipment. First off, I want to talk about is the supplies and material that's going to come with the machine itself so you can get it into production. It's going to come with a process container, a media separation container, a media collection tool, kilo of media, depending on what size, you might get multiple or just one, as well as a half gallon deburring solution. All these are going to be very pertinent when it comes to processing parts in the spinner machine. Now let's take a moment and we'll step over and look at how to operate the unit. So what we're looking at here is a control panel for our 750 model. All the panels are going to look very similar. They're all going to have the same timers, potentiometer, direction switch, as well as your start and your power source. This PLC here does not need to be touched. This is programmed and locked, so you can just leave this alone. Your timer is just going to be an up and down toggle. So I can set a minute here. I want to go 60 hertz. So 60 hertz with this machine equals 1800 RPMs. I'm going to go forward. So at first, when I hit the start button, I'm going to see a minute at 60 hertz going forward. This second timer I can set to 1 minute at 60 hertz in reverse or counterclockwise. This right here is going to be the differentiators when programming the machine. It's very simple. Timer, speed, and direction. Now we're going to walk through a little bit of the processing of your parts. So what I got here is I have a bucket on my machine. I'm going to go ahead and grab my media. 1 kilogram for a small 728 bucket. I'm going to spread my media out in there. I'm going to add in some aluminum parts for deburring. Some tap water. You want to put just enough water in to cover your parts. You're not looking to fill the bucket up. You're not even looking to fill it up halfway or even cover your center hub. Just enough to cover your parts. And then our solution is usually mixed around 100 to 1. So in this case here, I'm going to put in just a little over a capful. With that being said, I have kind of what I would call charge my bucket here, ready with the media, solution, water mixture, and my parts. So at this point, I'm ready to set my timer, my speed, my direction, and push the start button. Okay, at this point, my machine has came to a complete stop after processing the parts. What I always recommend is going ahead and turning the machine on just long enough to get the parts ramped up again. That's going to allow us to demag our parts. That way we can do a complete degauss. So I'm just going to turn my machine on. I'm going to let it ramp up here a little bit. And now I'm just simply going to remove the bucket. Now at this point, I want to go ahead and just skim off my water. I always like to just maybe put a little bit of water in there to kind of knock the suds down a little bit. Do a little rinse. And now we're going to go back to the same machine that we just done our deburring and go ahead and use our media separation container. I'm going to go with my parts and media into the bucket. Okay, now again, with my parts and media in the bucket, I'm just simply going to place my lid over top, turn the machine on, and let it run for a moment. What this is going to do is I slowly lift it up. It's going to allow us to get what we would consider about 100% separation. I have my parts here, media, and the catch container. I just want to thank you again today for taking the time to watch our quick startup and tips and tricks guide on the spinner deburring equipment. If you guys have any questions concerning the equipment or just anything else inside the Techniks Tool Group umbrella, please feel free to call the 800 number, 800-597-3921, and we'll be more than happy to answer those for you. Just want to thank you again and have a great day.